Hello guys, welcome to Futuristic Approach. This tutorial will focusing on exploratory data analysis, wherein we will do the data analysis using pandas. So I'll put the link in description regarding this page. You open this page towards data science, and this will tell you regarding what is exploratory data analysis in Python. So nowadays what happens, the data are generated in quintuples, millions and trillions of data are generated every day, and those data are used by various companies to track the kind of behavior of anyone. Like let's say I am using my phone and let's say iPhone, so they will start showing you the ads of iPhone, then like that. Then you will surprise that yesterday I checked my check the price of iPhone X or iPhone XR or whatever, and day after again tomorrow you are being shown on the ads, like you while watching YouTube you are seeing ads of iPhone or something like that. Then you will be amazed, but it is not something magic which is happening. It's all about the data processing which is happening using machine learning. So you have been kept in a category wherein the people, you know, like you are having a similar interest, have been kept in a group and then targeted on a based on your interests. So that is all about the machine learning, guys. It's a very interesting topic. Data science and machine learning are the trending topics in today's world, and in next 10 years it will be trending like anything. It will be the most highly paid jobs as well as highly demanding jobs into coming futures. So you can make your career in data science or machine learning. It's a part of artificial intelligence, because artificial intelligence is a huge topic and machine learning is a part of it. So it's based on your interest. You can choose your career, and I would suggest you go for this, because this is going to be the future of the world. Analysis is understanding the data sets and summarizing their main characteristics, and how you'll summarize it by using pandas, and then plotting them using matplotlib so that you can understand it visually, that what is happening in this. There are many ways to do it, and Python is one of the most popular one where you perform the exploratory data analysis. So the graphs which can be plotted in this is it can be a scattered plot or box plot, or you can use a histogram. So let us start the coding and understand the things how it is done. So if you read this, then you will come to know what exactly is data analysis, how data analysis is performed, what kind of data we are exploring in this case. Then the data sets which we will be exploring today is available over here. You can go to Kaggle website also. Kaggle is a data set website wherein you can search for any number of data, like data belonging to cars. You can write, if you type it, cars data, and it will give you data sets regarding used car data sets, US car data sets, Stanford cars data sets, and like that. So there are many data sets which are available at this site. You can use it, you can download it, and you can practice your machine learning algorithm on this. So you can just click here, the data sets will be downloaded. And then I have already downloaded it. Then what you have to do, you have to copy that data and open your terminal, and you write Jupyter Notebook over here. Once you write Jupyter Notebook, it will open a server for you, and which will be opened in a browser. I have already done it. So here is my Jupyter Notebook which has opened. Then you go to your document where you have kept that data. Like I had kept in my documents and in this EDA, this data.csv, and then after coming to this particular folder, you open, go to new and click on Python 3. So it will open a new notebook over here. You see the new notebook, If you don't do that, if you open a Jupyter Notebook Python terminal in some other folder, then you won't be able to read the data. So that is most important. Most of us do that mistake by keeping data in another folder and trying to explore it in another one or open it in another one. So that will not happen. So now I have already written on the codes, guys, because I don't want to waste your time. I had already written over here. So I'll explain you what all things mean what and how we are going through. So first thing you have to do is to import panda as pd. I'll zoom it out the main. Import panda as pd, then import numpy as np and matplotlib for plotting, that is matplotlib.pyplot as plt. Then after importing all these, you can read the data. The name of the data was data.csv, as you can see over here. This data.csv, the same name you have to keep it here. So Python, all those who are familiar with the panda data frame, you will be aware that how to read data frame. So df equal to pd.read.csv and name of the csv. Once you give this, I'll just write df. I'll comment it out, df.head4 first. Now it will print me the entire data sets. See, these are the entire data sets. So there are 11914 rows and 16 columns. We are not interested in the entire thing right now. So I'll put df.head4. So if I put df.head4, it will print me first four rows. Now similarly, the last four line, if you want to see, so you can write df.tail4. It will show you the last four, like 11910, 911, 912, 913. This is df.tail. Then another function of panda is df.describe. So if you describe something, it will give you mean, maxima, minima, 25%, 50%, 75%, standard deviations, everything it will be shown over here. So you can easily find out things. Then df.shape. Df.shape is nothing but number of rows and number of columns. If I put df.shape, it will tell me that 11914 rows are there and 16 columns are there. Then what kind of data are available in that row, that we can find it out using df.dtype. So if I put df.dtype, it will tell me make is object kind of thing, model is object kind of thing, year is obviously int 64, it will be because it is a number, engine fuel type and like that, cylinder is a float type because some point number will be there. You can see engine cylinder 5.6, that is why it is float. So this way you can make out. Now the data which has been given over here, we must be having duplicate items. For example, the same kind of thing will be repeated in n number of rows, so all such rows are required to be removed. So how you will find out the duplicate rows is another attribute called duplicate rows df equals to df.duplicated. This will tell you the entire how many duplicate items are available. So if I print the number of this duplicated rows df over here, then it will tell me the number of columns and number of rows with duplicated values, that is 715 and 16. These duplicated values are required to be removed. So okay, so before removing, you can give a count how many are there. You can see make 11914, model is 11914, and like that you have all kind of things. So now what you will do, you will drop the duplicated items. So you just do it like df equals to df dot drop duplicates, this will, and then print df5. When you do that, it will drop the duplicated items. And now when you do the df.shape, it will tell you it is 11199 column and 16 rows. Earlier it was, you can see, 11914 columns and 16 rows, and now it is 11199, so around 715 columns, 15 rows have been dropped. All right, with 16 columns, so columns will be the same. All right, so the rows with duplicated items have been removed. Here we come for the actual thing now. So now we have to plot the graphs. All right, so when you have to plot the graph, you will be able to visualize it. Right now, if I give you this data, you won't be able to understand what exactly it is. unless you go in each and every column, which is not obviously feasible for anyone to go for 11,000 columns and then 16 rows. So you won't be able to make out. If I give it to someone, he won't be able to make out. So for that we have Matplotlib. So Matplotlib gives you a visual graphic visual kind of thing, wherein you can visualize the things, that how the behavior of this data, what is this data is all about. So that is what is written over here. So here we have df dot make dot value counts dot nth largest 40 dot plot and kind equal to var in. So I'll tell you the meaning of this. Basically it is saying that you count the value of based on the make, you count the value and go till the largest of basically from highest to lowest till 40th of the term. So that means here we have make. So based on make, what it will do, it will count the number of cars, car make, like BMW is having 90 number of cars, Mercedes-Benz is having 110 number of cars, Rolls-Royce is having 120 number of cars. So based on that, it will segregate it in descending order. The most number of cars produced by the company will be in the first case, and so on, and it will keep on decreasing like that. So if I just comment it out and if I plot this, you see here we have Chevrolet is having the maximum number of cars based on how this data has come. This data has come from this one, this entire thing is 11,000 something rows. So that row is having Chevrolet cars, the highest number of cars is in Chevrolet, then Ford, then Toyota and Volkswagen, Nissan and so on and so forth. So if I give this graph to anyone, he can easily visualize it. But right now we don't know, we have not written what is there in the x-axis, what is there in the y-axis. So for that we have to write plt.title. Title will be your center on here, that number of cars by make. Then plt.ylabel, it will tell you the y-axis what is there, and plt.xlabel will tell you the legends over here, that is make. So Ford make, Toyota make, like that. So if you just comment it out and then you run the, so now in number of cars, now anybody can visualize it, that make, like Kia make car is having a, Kia has produced around 200 cars. All right. So this kind of data is very easy to visualize it, rather than having this kind of data. That is why this Matplotlib is important in this case. And you can change, like I don't want to see for 40th number of this thing, so I'll just change it to 5, let's say. The first 5 I would like to say. When I plot this, it will tell me only till, you see, beautiful. Chevrolet, Ford, Toyota, Volkswagen, Nissan. So it depends on how much you want. So nth largest is basically is coming in the descending order, and till descending order, like for the maximum to till 5th one. So that is what it is saying. So if I and this fixed size is nothing but the figure size. You can change it to, like, say, let's say 30, and I would take 15, then it will just increase the size of the figure, you see. So depends on you what you want to keep it. So I'll just keep it default only 25. All right, here you can change make. Instead of make, you can use model number also. Based on model number, you want to make a value counts on these, it will tell you, or engine fuel type, engine HP, or some, whatever you feel like doing. So it is all up to you how you want to explore it. That is why it is called analysis of data. The more you try your hands on, the more you will get the data, and the visual picture will be more clear in this case. Similarly, you can use a scatter plot also. So I'll comment it out. scatter plot is a standard function. If you want to plot a scatter plot, then you just put scatter plot and then df against what you want to put, like against HP, engine HP and MSRP, that is price. So based on these two things you want to make a graph, then you just run it. I'll tell you regarding the engine HP and this price. So engine horsepower, so you see that the more horsepower, like 1000 horsepower, the more is the price. The lesser the horsepower, lesser this will be the cost. So based on the capacity of engine, it has plotted the graphs. Similarly, you can change it from engine HP and MSP to instead of engine HP, engine cylinder also you can take, or driven wheels will be generally really 4 only, so you don't need to change that. Then number of doors will be also same only, it will be 4 or 2. Then year of you can, what you can do, you can engine horsepower and price, then you can take year also. So let's say I put it year instead of engine HP, I put year, then I plot it. You see, so 1990 the price was something less, then it has slowly increased, then increased, then 2-3 it has increased more, and like basically it is whatever data which is available to us, it is plotting the result of that data. All right, so this is what is used in machine learning in deriving the models, and based on that model you do the predictions. So that is all guys. If you have any doubts, then you can drop a comment in the comment section and I'll try to clarify it to the extent possible. So that's all. Yeah. Alright guys, thank you very much for watching me, and keep watching such videos, and let me know any particular videos if you want on machine learning or any topic related to AI, and I'll try to cover it in my next video. Alright, thanks.